right-hand side and compare the sky on the horizon and look higher up. It's particularly for those of you on the left, if you look higher up, good view of the moon as it's starting its new shape. And you can see the difference of colour, and it's just a magnificent view. At the same time, a little bit difficult to tell the curvature of the Earth. This is something which we can see quite clearly when we're going over somewhere like Egypt, supersonically high altitude, where there is no cloud, and yet we have a very good horizon in relation to the Earth from Earth cloud and sky. Whilst looking out, perhaps touch the Perspex window, and you'll see how warm it is in comparison to when you've been flying subsonic airplanes. It's quite simple for this, is it just beyond the Perspex, where the actual window is formed that holds pressure inside the cabin. Beyond that, the temperature is 90 degrees Celsius. 90 degrees Celsius, just under the temperature of boiling water. That is the same temperature around the leading edge of the wings of the aircraft. And on the nose, presently, we have a temperature of 115 degrees, which is quite low. This is due to the fact that we have a cold outside air. It's minus 59, as you can see, which very often it can be considerably warmer than that. And with that comes a higher temperature on the nose. We have a limit of 127 degrees Celsius. So with that, of course, and for those of you who remember your physics from your O and A-level days, we have the coefficient of the expansion of aluminium, which is extremely prone to expansion with temperature, and the airplane expands about 8 inches. So obviously with that, you can imagine the complications of getting an aircraft together when it expands 8 inches and flying supersonically and then retracts back to its original state for landing. Imagine all the air conduits that are driving up and down above you and below you. Linked, of course, to the flying controls, or hydraulic lines, all these things have to be capable of expansion. We're often asked about the visor and nose. The visor is a shield that protects the windshield of the aircraft. It allows us to streamline so that we can fly supersonically. This is lowered below 270 knots. At the same time, the nose goes down 5 degrees so as to help us to be able to get some better visibility. On landing, when we lower the undercarriage, we then lower the visor down to a position of 12.5 degrees as the attitude of the aircraft becomes steeper so that we can yet again see a good visibility for the landing phase. One of the amazing things about Concorde again is its engine setup. We have ramps and what we call secondary nozzles, which we suppose we could just call reverse buckets. They're quite complex on Concorde. But if I start with the ramps, once we go supersonic, we have to maintain a subsonic flow into the intakes of the jet engines. And to enable us to do this, we lower a couple of ramps. And through the sonic shocks, we eventually arrive in a space of just some 15 to 20 feet airflow, which was previous to its entry at Mach 2, eventually arrives into the compressors at Mach 4.5, around about 340 or so miles away, into its intake. So you can imagine the cleverness of being able to get airflow, which is not turbulent, but smooth, and it enters into the compressors in a short period of time at a much, much reduced flow. Some supersonic air going into the compressors obviously would result in sonic shocks and obviously a destruction of the turbine engines. This is not something we want. The secondary nozzles at the back of the aircraft, they become divergent, and through aerodynamic phase, we eventually arrive so that it produces 25% of the thrust of the aircraft when we are supersonic as we are now. 25% of the thrust has arrived at aerodynamically at the front end, 25% at the back end of the reverse buckets, and only 50% is produced by the jet engine itself while we are supersonic. Now the latest weather we have now, ladies and gentlemen, for New York is we should be landing towards the northeast. We have a northeasterly wind at present time at 10 miles an hour. There is some misty conditions and some drizzle. It's overcast at about 1,100 feet, 17 degrees Celsius, 63 degrees Fahrenheit. Local time is now 4:20, 20 minutes past 4 in the afternoon, be on again on schedule, just announced.
We'd like to welcome you to New York's John F. Kennedy Airport, where the local time is 12 minutes past 5 in the afternoon. For your safety, please remain seated with your seatbelt fastened, leaving all your items and hand luggage safely stowed until the seatbelt signs have been switched off by the captain. Before you leave Concorde today, please ensure that you have all your personal items and hand luggage with you. And do take care when you're opening any of the lockers in case items fall out and cause injury. On behalf of all the crew, I'd like to wish you a safe and pleasant onward journey, and thank you once again for choosing to fly to New York, British Airways Concorde today. A very good evening to you all.